'Tis a good thing that I save before I pick a lock or steal something, because I would have had to redo about 20 minutes of stuff there. The game is crashed. Here we are back. Crashed after I put down a few of these lake lurks. Speaking of, I'd probably better save it. Yep, the game runs so much faster on Xbox One, but it seems even more prone to crashing than on
3 seconds. Have you ever wanted to be invisible? We're okay on Stimpaks. Medex reserves empty.
Pretty badass rebreather without a...
You're my best friend forever.
Must be all about the vacuum tube technology. Universe. Yep, seeing how Lake Mead is at the moment, I bet it would probably take a good 1500 years for it to get this high again. Imagine the water usage of New Vegas cut down a little bit after the bombs fell. I'm not going in this cave because it's only like pre-war.
Thank you.
Got a few lake lurks up here still, I think. There is a skill book. It's made it all the way out west. And the author of that book, I know, used quite a few speech checks to flub. So I don't think the information is entirely accurate. Actually pretty damn good place to live in the post-apocalypse. Fresh water, fish, defensible. Okay, back to you.
Starting combat. Just kidding.
Normally, with this place, I would grab the rocket launcher out of Eddie and spam it. But I'm gonna get a little closer.
This one looks pretty tough.
Thank you. star caps do I got? Seven more. Make the treacherous journey to Bitter Springs.
Hey. Wow. Hey, it's you. What are you doing in Bitter Springs? I'd love to help you out, but I'm pretty strapped here as it is. I really don't have anything to sell you. That's not the worst intro.
I thought this guy had a quest.
Hey.
This save and before pickpocket theft will become ever more important when I do my Skyrim remaster playthrough this fall. Why isn't it theft to steal 5 mil?
This is the worst detail in the Mojave.
Think that. Where is the man?
Never expected someone as famous as you to turn up here. What can I do for you? It's a distress call. This camp is in bad shape, and if we don't get relief soon, I don't know what will happen. At this point, I'll take anything you can give me. We need more troops, fresh supplies, and medical relief. As if that wasn't enough, someone's been coming out of the mountains at night, stealing supplies and picking off my people. Food, blankets, clothes, tools. The army used to ship out caches of supplies regularly. But with the Legion so active, we haven't gotten any in months. I don't know. The NCR's stretched thin as it is. I've put in requests at Camp Golf, Forlorn Hope, McCarran, but things are no better there. Maybe if their situations improved, they'd have men to spare. Or maybe they'd listen to someone with a reputation for helping the NCR. It started about 6 months ago. At first it was just supplies going missing. We figured it was refugees. Then people started dying. Always a single bullet to the head. Always from extreme range. We've lost 8 refugees and 3 soldiers to this son of a bitch. We know he must be hiding out in one of the caves up in the mountains, but I don't have enough men to send out looking for him. You'll want to talk to Lieutenant Markland about that. He's our medical officer. He should be down at the medical tent now. This is the Bitter Springs refugee camp. We've been maintaining it for a few years now, ever since Caesar's Legion started seriously pushing west. Most of the people here were displaced by the Legion's advance. At first, there weren't many. But lately, it's been more than we can handle. This whole area used to be a Great Khan encampment before they relocated to Red Rock Canyon. We just haven't had the manpower to clean it all up yet. Good luck.
A lot of these NPCs can accidentally get killed and quests fail. During Boone's quest. So it's good that we came here beforehand.
Hello. Yeah? What is it? Hey, if you can help, I'll take whatever I can get. Doctor's bags would be a huge help, but what I really need are medical texts. I'm not trained to deal with major psychological trauma, and we've got a lot of kids in this camp. Both of them? Wow, that's very resourceful. Thank you. Thank you. This will keep us well stocked for a good long while. I think that should just about cover us. I really don't know how to thank you. Your bringing me these supplies saved a lot of people. Oh yeah, sure, I think I can spare a little. Here, and thanks again.
What brings you to Ranger Station Bravo? We're here to make sure the Legion doesn't try to sneak around Lake Mead and come at NCR from another direction. Yep.
Where is the comm officer?
You're here to sell something. We don't want any. No problem. Hey, do me a favor when you get back to Reyes and tell her that we don't need any more damn ammo. Wouldn't mind more water, though. We're not gonna die of thirst anytime soon, but I'd rather have too much than not enough. You think I haven't tried? Every time I do, Camp Golf acknowledges the situation. And soon after that, more ammo. It's not my call to make. You'd have to clear it with Ranger Erickson. This is the frontier of NCR territory, and we're the first line of defense. You won't find much in the way of civilization east of here. South of here is Camp Guardian, but they've been having radio trouble, so they've been silent for a while now.
Something up? You're not stationed here, but your rep with the NCR speaks for itself. It's mostly rifle rounds, but I'll throw in a few boxes of pistol ammo. I really shouldn't be doing this for you, but there's no way we're gonna use all of this or be able to carry it with us. Yep.
Super mutants to take out over here. And a bomb that's clearly a reference to Tsar Bomba Soviet nuke.
Oh.
Time to fight. Cessation of hostilities complete. Ready, steady, fighty. Cessation of hostilities complete.
That thing didn't go off, huh? Get a new gun for one of our companions down here.
This one looks pretty tough. Cessation of hostilities complete. Uh-oh. What's that?
Mr. House couldn't get. is everyone? This is not quite the point of no return, but it's close. I'm gonna get Beware the Wrath of Caesar and Don't Tread on the Bear.
I hear you're going to help us. I hope you're up for the... It's going to be a dream come true once you've raised that bomber from Lake Mead. That's tremendous. I'll transmit instructions to the robots to start packing up the plane to bring it back to Nellis. I just told you, the robots are going to handle it. They'll break the plane down into pieces and move it up from Colville Bay in one shot. Exactly. We'll be shelling an unoccupied location in Outer Vegas to get their attention elsewhere. By the time they realize they aren't under attack, the plane and the bots will be long gone. The kids wish we were shelling a real target, but Pearl thinks it's wise not to start up a war just as the lady has risen.
You'll get a chance to bomb some people on my behalf.
Hey, I'd better get rolling. Jack and I have a lot of work ahead of us. Isn't that bump?
That's a good thing to see, huh, boss? That loyal guy. He's getting up there in years, but he still finds a way to make himself useful to his people. If you ask me, that's better than withering away all alone or holding on to some faded piece of glory from your past. Yeah, that's what I thought, too. Old history, boss. I left everything when I left Mexico. My home, my family, my name, even my face. I know it's surprising, boss, but I wasn't always just handsome. As far as the world knows, I was Miguel. And I was okay with that. I headed north for a while and ended up in Tucson. Not Tucson, by the way. Things were good there. Well, maybe not good. But better than Mexico City anyway. I found myself a little shack, started fixing things. Well, sure, boss. I was always good at fixing things. Some I fixed for the town, some I fixed for other people, some I fixed just for the hell of it. It's a better way to use your hands than killing. And even then, I wasn't getting any younger or faster. I lived there for a long time, kept to myself, didn't get into any fights. Hell, the only reason I even kept my guns oiled was professional pride. Getting there, boss, I'd been in Tucson. The locals can call it Tucson all they want, but it's Tucson, damn it. About 75 years when she showed up. Prettiest thing you ever saw, boss. Maybe it was just a trick of my senile brain, but I swear she looked just like my Rafaela. Her name was Claudia. She ended up taking work at one of the brothels in town. I never went to her, of course. How could I? But I looked after her in my own way. This was a long time ago, before Caesar's Legion pacified Arizona and brought the raider tribes to heel. A tribe came into Tucson one day. More a gang, really. Dirty Dave and his six brothers. They were looking for bullets, and I sold some to them. I figured if I did that, they'd leave town before they tore it up too much. No, boss. No, they didn't. As I was saying, I hoped they'd leave the town in peace. Instead, they decided to stop at Claudia's brothel to take the edge off. I don't know which one of them got rowdy first, but by the time I heard the screams and got my guns, it was too late. They shot up the brothel, killed four girls, and taken Claudia for their sport. I went after Dave and his brothers. They had a head start, but they slept nights. I didn't. It took me 3 days to catch up to them. Claudia was dead when I got there. They put a bullet in each of her eyes. I couldn't do anything except avenge her, just like Rafaela. I charged into the middle of their camp and started firing. Two of them were dead before they knew I was there. The other five, though, they shot the shit out of me. I would have died, I think, if I wasn't so full of rage. By being a meaner old cuss than the rest of them, boss, I wanted to keep living until they weren't. So I just kept shooting until they were all dead. I was in pretty bad shape in the end, though. I don't know how long I laid there, with the sun baking me and the buzzards chomping at me. Eventually, I got the strength to start moving. Some long time after that, I managed to drag my carcass back to town. When I recovered, more or less anyways, I left Tucson and headed west. I ran into Tabitha at Black Mountain, and well, the rest you know. I swore I was done with the gunslinging life. I was too old, too slow, and too beat up to protect anyone anymore. I thought I was done forever, but after traveling with you, I realized I've always had my doubts about whether I still had what it took to carry my pistols proudly, to use them to do what's right. And now that I've been traveling with you for a while, you've made me realize that I can still do that. Maybe I'm not as tough as I used to be, but my brains can make up for that, and my hands are still quick enough. It's time to put the guns back on. You can bet on that, boss.
The Vaquero outfit now. See, that's just an unmarked quest. I don't know why it's unmarked. It shouldn't be marked. That's as good as any other companion quest in the game. I didn't even know about them. Like I said before, I could have checked the wiki, but I didn't for the first couple playthroughs. I didn't even know about that whole interaction with Raul, because you have to talk to the three elderly. Two elderly in CR and Royal. So I think next up is to, it's either Cass's or Arcade's quest. I'll decide when I get back.
Hello, friend. How can Mother Pearl be of help today? What you have done for us is a miracle, child. You have fulfilled the only dreams we ever had outside our walls. You are a trusted friend of us all. If there is ever a way for us to help you, child, tell me, and I will make it so.
I need you to bomb the hell out of the
Of course, my child. After all that you have done for us, we would love to help you in the upcoming battle. After all the training in virtual reality, the young ones would relish an opportunity to put their skills to battle. We'll be there when you need us. Bye.
I expect to be awed by your dizzying mercantile sense, boss.
Since we have to go back the Lucky 38 anyways, I'm gonna make a big stop at the We'll pick it back up when we're in the Lucky 38 and we're back into the house, but basically I'm just going to do some ammo shuffling so I can make use of those two weapons that Eddie has in his inventory. So that's what we'll do when we